You respect their ability. They're all set to go in the cup. All ready. Foster's Melbourne Cup. Light is on. Racing in the cup. Sub-Zero, one of the first ones out of the gates was Silk Darley, who crosses over to the fence in front of his arm first and Vintage Crop. Then came Field Officer. Wider out was Drum Taps. He's racing hand into the lead, as is Marrakesh. He goes around them out wider, followed by Frontier Boy. Next, Tiako Nick, and out Pompey's four wide with the Phantom, and they were followed by Fra. Getting back was Cavalieri from Dancing Lord Air Seattle. Out Tristolite's midfield with Slight Chance, and Castletown goes back to the rear of the field now with his arm Mercator, and the mare Diamond Base is last of all. Down the straight the first time, and going to the lead is Fra. Fra by a length and a half to the stablemate Marrakesh, and now Tiako Nick goes up to be second. The Phantom was fourth, and out Tristolite the Grey was three wide. Then Drum Taps on the outside of Vintage Crop, and out Pompey three deep. They were followed by Slight Chance. A half a length further back then to Young Pirate, then Silk Ali on the rails. Frontier Boy stepping around the mat four wide now, and then came Field Officer. Over on the inside, Tennessee Jack, and then came Cavalieri out of the straight. Ultimate Aim three off the rail, tracked up by Air Seattle. Then Great Vintage and Dancing Lord, one length away, Castletown. Then came Azam Mercator, and Diamond Bases was last of all as they head to the back of the track. They have 2,000 metres left to travel along the Maribyrnong side of the track. And Tiako Nick in front, three quarters of a length. Frontier Boy was second, one and a half to Fra. The Phantom fourth on the outside, then Merrick is the rails. A half to Drum Taps, getting one off the rails. Three wide was out Tristolite. Then Silk Ali racing inside Vintage Crop. Out Pompey was three deep. Then Young Pirate on the outside of Tennessee Jack. Out wider was Slight Chance, and then Field Officer. Last year's winner, Sub-Zero, a bit worse than midfield on the inside. Ultimate Aim was three deep, and then Great Vintage the centre. Dancing Lord the inside. Cavalieri hooked out almost four wide. Then came Azam. On its inside, Mercator, a half to Air Seattle, Castletown. And two lengths away, last of all, Diamond Bases. And she is 15 lengths off the leader, Tiako Nick. 1,300 metres to go on the Foster's Melbourne Cup. Tiako Nick by one length to Frontier Boy. Three lengths away, third was the Phantom on the outside of Fra. They were followed by Drum Tap, edging closer on the outside of Marrakesh. Vintage Crop behind them, and they were followed down on the inside by Silk Ali. Out Tristolite was deep. Tennessee Jack sneaking up on the inside as they approach the bend. Young Pirate wide, followed by Sub-Zero, one off the rail, Dancing Lord the inside. Field Officer was deep, and then Great Vintage. Ultimate A, Mercator, well back in the field, Cavalieri. Then came Azam. Further back as they come to the turn here, Seattle hard-ridden third last. Castletown second last, and Diamond Bases last. Up to the turn, Tiako Nick and Frontier Boy together. Three in front of the Phantom running on. Then Drum Taps over on the inside. Marrakesh and Fra both making up good ground. In the straight, it's Tiako Nick by a length. Frontier Boy second. Marrakesh to third, three lengths away, Fra. Then the Phantom, Vintage Crop is running on, and then Drum Taps. Down to the 300, Tiako Nick a length in front of Frontier Boy. Three away, Vintage Crop starting to storm home from Tennessee Jack. Tiako Nick in front. Vintage Crop is storming home on the outside. Vintage Crop on the outside grabs Tiako Nick and Mercator, and the cup is going back to England. And Vintage Crop has won the Melbourne Cup by three lengths to Tiako Nick and Mercator. Then Great Vintage crashing home for fourth. Close up in the field was Tennessee Jack, Frontier Boy. Then Drum Taps every chance, Marrakesh. Fra next home, Azam. Sub-Zero, Cavalieri. Well back in the field, the Phantom, Young Pirate, Air Seattle. Castletown, Dancing Lord. Then Silk Ali, Slight Chance. Ultimate Aim and Diamond Bases has finished at the tail without Tristolite. Vintage Crop has won the Melbourne Cup for Michael Kinane. We heard all about you, and he did not let us down.
Well, he just outstayed them, Danny. He was just far too good. The Phantom had every chance. Drum Taps had a beautiful run. This horse just seemed to relish the going, and he just worked right away. He was brought along at the right time by Michael Kinane. There he is. They look beautiful, both these horses in the mounting yard. And Vintage Crop, what a great win.
6, 5 and 10. Vintage Crop will pay $16.80 and $5.50. Tiako Nick, $14.90. What a gallant run. And Mercator, $30.70. And the trifecta will be a mammoth dividend. Fourth placing goes to number 23, Great Vintage. And fifth was number 16, Frontier Boy, a valiant effort to finish up in that position. Michael Kinane, the winning rider, he is trained over in Ireland, let's see, and what a performance, just a great staying effort and a terrific ride.
Michael Kinane here, the winning jockey of the Melbourne Cup 93. Like your first ride at Flemington.
Yeah, it's hard to beat this one.
There's about 80 or 90,000 people here today, Mike, and you came over here and the good judges said you could win, the good judges said you couldn't win. But you had a good run all the way?
Yeah, nice run. I was following Frankie on drum taps and Frankie suddenly dropped away before the home, and once I got the racing room, I was happy, you know. I was always going to win then.
Yeah, Mike, it's opened up the Melbourne Cup to the world now, isn't it? International race.
Ah, well, the country's becoming a small place. I think it's the right way. It makes everything.
I think it is, and also that we've a $2 million race. Is this your biggest one?
I think it's close to it, yes. Because it's today.
Well, mate, this is going to be one of the most memorable times you'll ever have in any country you've ridden in. So you better go in there, enjoy it, and good luck, mate. And it's nice to see you, see the Cup go overseas, and... So hopefully next year we've got a lot more of you guys over here.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Mike.
John Letts with Mike Kinane, and what a training performance. Dermot Weld, they said he couldn't do it, Pete, but he did.
And to my staff.
Yes, well, Dermot Weld has just joined us now. He's been besieged by the media as we go live around the world, Dermot, and back to Ireland. What would you like to say to the folks back home?
Oh, it was a great day for Ireland. And I just want to thank everybody for their help and everybody here in Australia who's made me very welcome.
How confident were you going into the race?
I was quietly confident. When the 2 inches of rain came last night, I was concerned. The horse did lose 7 kilos travelling out here, which is considerable, but he put it back on, and on Sunday morning when he worked, I was very pleased with him.
Did you take any heart to the criticism that was given about the preparation and the fact that it wasn't the Australian way?
That doesn't worry me at all. I've trained winners all over the world, so I'm used to criticism, but I do it my way, and I'm quite happy.
Throughout the race, were you happy?
I was a little bit concerned over the far side. He got once or twice stopped, but overall I was happy.
Well, drum taps too. The other horse ran a bold race as well. It truly is an international race now.
I've always believed it to be, and I've always wanted to come here and do it since I landed in Australia many years ago.
Do you think this will enhance the reputation of the Melbourne Cup overseas?
The Melbourne Cup will develop to be the international two-mile race of the world.
And finally, Irish eyes will be smiling tonight.
I hope so.
Dermot Weld, congratulations.
Thank you.
Dermot Weld, the trainer. And Vintage Crop is about to come back into the mounting yard after the running of the Foster's Melbourne Cup. Well, as I said, it really is truly an international race now. And great scenes of joy down here in the mounting yard as this wonderful galloper, the winner of the Irish St. Ledger, now caps off months and months of preparation. It's cost the connections of both Vintage Crop and Drum Taps a lot of money to get here, but every single cent they have spent over the past 6 months is now worth it as Vintage Crop comes back to scale after winning the Foster's Melbourne Cup. What a great moment, and Dermot Weld certainly a very happy man at the moment. Vintage Crop returning to scale, and there is the group.
Every chance?
Yeah, just running slow for us.
Right. What about Kevin Moses, Cavalieri?
Oh, mate, they just went too slow and I was too far back.
Right. What about you?
Pulled too hard, I just couldn't stop them.
Grant, any no luck at all, Silk Alley?
I had all luck, just...
Darren, every chance for him?
Every chance, didn't say distance.
Right, what about you, Mick? Caught wide?
The ground. Well, he caught out off the track, but the ground didn't suit him well. He was beat a long way out.
Our Pompeii, that was. Stephen, what about Great Vintage? Good run?
Yeah, I was really happy with her. You know, she got back and it was a muddling sort of race, so she got home really good. Next year will be her year.
Jimmy, what about the Phantom?
I had a beautiful run. I travelled good, but the rain affected me. I travelled good to the half mile, and then when I the pressure come on, I dipped and dived in the ground. So
it was very hard for him. And Vintage Crop beat me 11 weights before by 5 lengths, yeah. And today I had to give him 3 kilos. So I think the best horse won on the day. It was a bit too much of a hard task for my horse to win with 58 and a half.
When were you beating half the
ride? About 800. You know, I was staying on one pace.
Greg, what about Sub Zero?
Every day you got too much weight, Jim.
Nolly, what about Castletown?
No, he didn't head out too good. He didn't head out too good. Like, early part was okay, but I was tracking McCady. He's got up to run third. But, well, his action wasn't too good.
What about Tennessee Jack, Damien?
Yeah, he ran a great race. I thought he was a winning chance on the corner, and then he just knocked up a little bit towards the end. Probably not quite seasoned enough for the 2 miles.
Good on you, Damien. Michael Clark, what about Marrakesh?
Good honest run, Teddy. He travelled nicely. He just knocked up. He just wasn't good enough the last 400.